you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. The 4th of July, I used to refer to it as Independence Day before I got married. When I was a kid, we always had fireworks on July the 4th. We used to tie a 20-pound firecracker to a box of dynamite and then drop it down a well. Don't laugh, that's how the Grand Canyon got started. And once on July 4th, the kids tied my brother to a 6-foot skyrocket and set it off. That's how he got to California 20 years before I did. When my brother went to school, he had a nickname. They used to call him Aloha Hope. He was always waving his hand and leaving the room. The school saved a lot of money on my brother, though. Whenever he sat in the corner, they didn't need a dunce cap for him. The teacher just painted his head white. And the weather's wonderful. The weather's been so warm around here that a lot of people have gone swimming. Of course, here in California, you can go swimming all year round. All you need is a bathing suit, a picnic lunch, and something sharp to punch a hole in the ice. I went to the beach the other day, and I was having a wonderful time in the water until the lifeguard swam out, pointed at my nose, and said, "How many times do I have to tell you? No spearfishing." But I really think I should get a more modern bathing suit. I didn't realize how old-fashioned mine was until I noticed two ladies from Pasadena staring at me. Then one nudged the other and said, "Martha, you've always wanted to get Gertrude Edderly's autograph. Well, now's your chance." On Independence Day, we should all stop for a moment and realize what a wonderful country we live in. To be a good American citizen, all you have to do is practice the golden rule, obey the laws, and don't try to cheat or swindle anybody. In other words, just live so your children won't run to their mother screaming, "Hey, Ma, I just saw Daddy on Dragnet."